Dear students, today we are going to start with worksheet 1 of the chapter Ratio and Proportion. Let's start solving some questions of worksheet 1. Question number 1. Find the value of x if the terms are in continued proportion. Let's see first question 25, 35, x. According to the formula, b square is equal to ac. Here we are taking 25 as a, 35 as b, and x as c. So 35 square is equal to 25 multiply x. 35 is squared, that means 2 times we can write 35 multiply 35 is equal to 25 multiply x. Then we will transpose 25 to the left hand side. We will get 35 multiply 35 upon 25, that is 5 5s are 25, 5 7s are 35, then 5 1s are 5 and 5 7s are 35. And then we will multiply 7 with 7, so we will get 49 is equal to x. This is the value of x in continued proportion. Let's start with second question 34, 68, x. Here also we'll do the same. B square is equal to AC. Here A is equal to 34, B is equal to 68, and C is equal to x. So 68 square is equal to 34 multiply x. 68 multiply 68 divided by 34 is equal to x. So according to the question, we will cut the number. 2 17s are 34, 2 34s are 68, then 17 ones are 17, and 17 twos are 34. So the value will be 68 multiply 2, that is 136 is equal to x. In this way we are going to solve the questions of continued proportion. Let's start with question number 2. The ratio of income to the expenditure is 7:6. Find the savings if the income is rupees 14,000. Here we are going to write the income is equal to 14,000. So income ratio expenditure proportionate to income ratio expenditure. So 7 upon 6 is equal to 14,000 upon x. Then we will cross multiply. 7 multiply x is equal to 14,000 multiply 6. That is x is equal to 14,000 multiplied 6 upon 7, that is 7 to the 14, and value of x will be 26 the 12,000. So therefore the expenditure will be rupees 12,000. And savings is equal to income minus expenditure, and the same income is given 14,000, and we have taken out the expenditure 12,000. Then we will subtract 14,000 from 12,000. We will get rupees 2,000. Next question is, find the mean proportion of the following. 5, 20. So according to the formula, we'll use b square is equal to ac. Here 5 is a and 20 is c. So b square is equal to 5 multiply 20. 520 is 100, so b square is equal to 100. Then we have to remove the squared sign, so we will put root 100, and for taking out the square root we will take out the using prime factorization, that is 250 is 100, 225 is 50, 55 is 25, and 51 is 5. As you can see, 2 is coming twice and 5 is coming twice. We will take it as 1. So 2 multiplied 5, that is 10, and 10 is the square root of 100. Let's see one more example, 7, 28. Here also we are using the same formula, b square is equal to ac. Here also a is equal to 7 and c is equal to 28. So b square is equal to 7 multiplied 28, that is 196. For removing the squared sign, we'll put under root sign at 196. Then we'll using prime factorization method of 196. 298s are 196, 249s are 98, 77s are 49, 71s are 7. As you can see here, 2 is coming twice and 7 is also coming twice. We'll take it as 1. So 2 7s are 14. So 14 is the square root of 196. In this way, we are going to solve these questions. to take out the mean proportion. Let's start with question number 4. The ratio of red marbles to green marbles is 2:5. If there are 12 red marbles, how many green marbles are there? So, we'll take out red ratio green proportionate to 12:green. Red are given 2:5 and 12 ratio will take it as green as X. So, 2/5 is equal to... So 2/5 is equal to 12/x. Then we will cross multiply these questions. 2 × x is equal to 12 × 5. So the value will become x is equal to 12 × 5, and we will transpose 2 to the right hand side. Then we will cut 2 with 12 with the same table. 2 × 1 = 2 and 2 × 6 = 12. So we'll get the answer 6 × 5 = 30. Therefore the green marbles will be 30. Let's start with the next question. Question number 5. Divide ₹2100 between Shruti and Monali in the ratio 4:3. Here, the Shruti's part is 4x and Monali's part is 3x. So when we'll add both the parts, that is 4x plus 3x, we will get 2100. So we will add 4x plus 3x, that is 7x is equal to 2100. Then we will transpose 7 to the right hand side. We'll get 2100/7, that is 7 × 3 = 21, and we'll get the answer as 300. So the Shruti's part will be 4 × 300, that is 1200, and Monali's part is 3 × 300, that is 900. So Shruti will get ₹1200 and Monali will get ₹900. Question number 6. In the mixture of 72 liters of milk and water, the ratio of milk and water is 5:3. Find the quantity of milk and water. So total quantity is 72 liters and milk is equal to 5x and water is equal to 3x. So 5x plus 3x is equal to 72. 5 plus 3 is 8x is equal to 72. Here we will transpose 8 on the right hand side. We'll get 8 × 9 = 72, that is x is equal to 9. So the value of x will be 9. Milk is equal to 5 × 9, that is 45 liters, and water is equal to 3 × 9, that is 27 liters. Now question number 7. As per a recipe book, 3 kg sugar is required with 5 kg mangoes to make mango jam. How much sugar would Ritu need if she wants to make a jam with 3 kg mangoes? Let the sugar be X. And if sugar is given 3 kg, so I need mangoes 5 kg. If sugar is X, so I need mangoes 3 kg. So let us make an equation. 3:x is proportionate to 5:3. That is 3/x is equal to 5/3. Then we will cross multiply. 3 × 3 = 9 and 5 × x. So 3 × 3/5 is equal to x. 3 × 3 = 9/5 is equal to x. That means the value of x will be 1.8. Therefore 1.8 kg of sugar is needed to make a jam with 3 kg mangoes. In this way we are going to solve questions of worksheet 1, and hope you have understood. And you thank you and have a nice day.